icons. So screen has been shared, and I believe you must have been through the concepts of quadratic expressions, and you must be knowing that what is a quadratic expression and what is a quadratic equation. So just to start with, I will give a very brief about approach through which I'll be solving most of the question, or you can always shift your approaches from one to another, whatever suits in a particular situation. So let's go through the concepts first. I'll not be detailing anything, and that will be very brief for you, so that you can visualize what a quadratic expression is, and how we can plot the graph and how we can solve the questions through the quadratic equation. So let's just go through the, just a minute. Just I've been stuck with this particular network problem here. Okay, so what I'll be doing is just realize that any quadratic expression, right, then if a particular dependent variable, which is y here, that has been expressed with x, where the order of x is 2. So y is equal to x square is basically an expression. So what we are doing here is we are expressing y with respect to x, and x is in second order. So when you plot this graph, basically you will have if x and y two values. If x is 0, then y will be 0 also. If x is 1, then y will be 1. If x is 2, then y will be 4. If x is minus 2, then y will again be 4. So basically what we see is the x will have all the values, and y will have only positive value, which is the square of x. So basically when you draw this particular graph, so this is your x axis, this is your y axis. So y will always be upward, because with every x, either in right side or left side, the graph is going upward. So any quadratic equation can be represented with a parabolic graph. Basically you don't need to understand what is a parabolic graph or what mathematics is behind it, but basically with respect to representation, you can always say so the graph will be parabolic, which is in this sense. So there will be a point minimum, and graph will either go upward or downward. So what do we see here is this particular curve denotes y is equal to x square. So what I'll be doing here is I'll be reaching the final point. I'll be reaching with the I'll be reaching here. What you know is that any quadratic equation that can be represented as expression that can be represented as ax square plus bx plus c. So what I'll be doing is I'll also represent the same quadratic equation in such a manner like m x minus or plus basically it's x plus n square plus p. So the same a square plus bx plus c, we can also represent the quadratic equation in this format also. What we have here is just a minute. Just try to understand this particular figure. So what happens if y is equal to x square is there, the curve will be like this. So what happens if you multiply 2 with x square? So what do you see here? That when you multiply 2 with the every value of y, so if x is 0, y again will be 0. If x is 1, y will be 2. If x is 2, y will be 8. So what happens? The y will be reaching the values before, much before where it was reaching earlier. So 4 will come early. So where the place is 4, it will be 8. So what will happen? The particular curve here, it was like this. This will got shrinked like this. So it will be shrinked like if it was the graph of x square, this will be graph of 2x square. And what we if we'll multiply x square with a number greater than 1. So what happens if we multiply x square with number greater than less than 1? So what will happen here? With the every value of x, there was a y before, and that y will be got half by this half. So what will happen? Basically, this was your graph of x square. So the graph of half x square will be little expanded than earlier. So this is what we get. Kindly remember or notice that every time graph is touching x-axis at point of origin. So every time it's touching the x-axis at point of origin. So what will happen if minus 1 will be multiplied to x square? Since the value of x square can never be negative, so only thing, the only way we can get minus y by multiplying x square by something which is minus. So what basically what I did was I multiplied minus 1 to that x square. So every value of y here, the every value of y here will get negative. So the graph, the same graph will be inverted. The same graph will be inverted. So we have a next curve. So what will happen if y will be a y, the same expression x square, if we add something, a constant term to the x square. So what will happen? Every value of y here, 2 will be added to these. So what will happen? And the y which was getting started at the place from this place earlier at the time of x square, so it will be start after 2. Every time we will add 2 with the to the particular value of y. So this graph will be shifted upward. So what do you see? That all these graphs is reaching a tip point, either going upward or either going downward. There is one value where we get the tip of the graph. So that point is our maximum or minimum point. So what do we see here is that if there is any inverted graph, it will always have a maximum value, and if there is any upward graph, it will always have a minimum value. So any quadratic expression which has a multiple of x square positive, if any coefficient of x square is positive, so graph will be upward, and if coefficient of x square is negative, graph will be downward. So what do we get here is this particular x square plus 2 has a positive coefficient on x square. So if 2 is added to this particular x square, so the whole graph will shift upward, and we will have a minimum value which will be called 2. So the next thing that we'll be dealing with is, what if something is added to x alone? What if something is added to x alone? So the next graph that I'll have plotted is y is equal to x plus 2 whole square of x plus 2. So what is happening here, the x like x plus 2 will also have all the values here, like x plus 2 can be 0, x plus 2 can be infinity, x plus 2 can be 4 or anything. So this graph would be the same, but only the minimum value where we were getting minimum value of y, that will be shifted to minimum value of y that will be shifted to at the place of minus 2. So where x is equal to minus 2, we will get this particular curve which was same as y is equal to x square. Let me open the question bar. Since then you can just watch the curves, how they are behaving with the different changes that we have brought to the equation. Are you all getting this particular concept, what I am doing here? Anurag, Suman, Varsha, okay, Anand, thank you. So what we are doing here is, we are trying to thanks a lot. So what we are doing here is, we are trying to sense the change that a graph can have by adding something to the x or by adding something to the complete expression. So every time you just need to realize that any quadratic expression which looks very big to you may not be very big as compared to that we have studied in our class. You just need to identify what is there to change what. So what if, let's go to our next graph. What if we subtract something from x, like we have our base equation is y is equal to x square. So what I have did is, I have subtracted something from the x. So now we have is y is equal to x minus 2 the whole square. So what do we see is that x minus 2 will always have all the values which x was having here. So x minus 2 will have 0, x minus 2 will have 1, x minus 2 will have 2, x minus 3, likewise. And similarly minus 1, minus 2. So all the values on a number line, x minus 2 will always have those. But the only thing is that y is equal to 0 only if x minus 2 is equal to 0. So x is equal to 2 will be our base point. So from here the curve will start. And the curve will have same width or same height as compared to y is equal to x square. So there is nothing change in term of width of the curve or anything. Just there is one change is there, that is the minimum point has been shifted from 0 to 2. So now we have all the square terms here. So what if the term has been written in this way, y is equal to x plus 2 whole square minus 6. So what do we see here is, basically x has been added with 2, So the minimum point will go to the minus 2, and it has been also subtracted by 6. So the curve will not from start like this, rather this will go downward, little downward, little, not little, is exactly minus 6 point below from the x-axis. So the same curve will start from this point. So what we have is our minimum value of y as minus 6. So if any quadratic equation you want to find out maxima or minima, so you can just convert that particular quadratic equation in this format, and you can always get what is the value of maximum, maxima or minima of the particular quadratic equation. So one thing to remember, that this m doesn't affect the maximum or minimum value. Similarly, this a will not affect maximum or minimum value of the quadratic equation. So only thing that we have is x plus n. So with this n, you can find out at what point of x the curve will have maximum or minimum. And finally, you can always have this p as the maximum or minimum value of the quadratic equation. To see an example here, I will just let me put something as an example. So let's go to the new page. So what do we have here is, let's say there is a quadratic expression that is x square plus 4x plus 8. So what is the minimum or maximum value, minimum or maximum value of this particular quadratic equation? So what you have to do here is, you just need to convert this particular quadratic expression in what format? Already I have told you, in this format, x plus n square plus p. So it's very simple here, it's look very simple here, but many of the time you can get a typical one. So it's basically a x square plus 4x plus 4. This will complete the square term, and you also have extra 4 here. So basically this is x plus 2 plus 4. So what do we see? That this particular quadratic equation will go upward. So because the coefficient of x square is plus 1. So this particular curve will go upward. So there is no point of having a maximum value. So this particular quadratic expression will have minimum value, and that is at x is equal to minus 2. Or the minimum value, the minimum value will be 4, and the point where you will get the x where you get minimum is minus 2. As I have already told you, to graph this, you can just say that this graph is, this point is minus 2, and let's say this point is 4. So particular graph will go like this. So this is the value where you get. So similarly, you can also see that whether this particular curve will have a solution or not. Like earlier, what we used to do is, of course, let me explain you with the same example. what we had in the previous, let me go back to the previous slide. Just a minute. What we were seeing that if x in this particular curve, in this particular curve, if y is equal to x square, if it is not y is equal to x square, but the this particular this here what we have the logic that y is equal to minus x square is there. So x square is multiplied by minus 1. So what do we see is every value of y here will get multiplied by minus 1. So we can only have negative y. So the curve will go downward. Curve will always go downward. So in this case, okay, just a minute. Okay, Narayan, I'm trying to get that. No, it's not always. I see P is not always the minimum value. Basically, P is P. If P is positive, and graph is upward, let me explain you with the example. And I'll go to another page only, next page only. So what do we have is, just a minute. So let's go with this. So what do we have here is that we have already seen if y is equal to minus x square, that means x square is being multiplied by a negative number. So earlier what we had is y is equal to x square. So every x there is a y, like f x is 0, y is 0, x is 1, y is 1, x is minus 1, y is again 1, x is minus 2, y is 4. So what do you see here? Whatever the value of x is, positive or negative, y is always positive. So that graph was moving upward. So y was starting at the point where x is equal to 0, and y was going upward. So where 1 is there on x, y also has 1. If 2 is there on x, y has a value of 4. So this particular point is 2, 4. So this curve was going upward. So any curve which is going upward will always have a negative minimum value. Because if the curve is going upwards, it will go till the infinity. So if we'll increase the value of x, y will also increase. So y will not have a maximum value. Y will have a maximum value infinity in this case. But the minimum value the y can have is 0. So what do we see is if y is equal to x square, or if the multiple of coefficient of x square is positive, y will always have minimum value. So if we have y is equal to minus x square, so if you'll again see the data how it goes, if x is equal to 0, y is equal to 0. If f is equal to 1, y is equal to minus 1. If x is equal to minus 1, y again minus 1. If x is equal to minus 2, y is minus 4. If x is equal to plus 2, y is 4. So what do we have here is y is always negative. So this graph, when you will plot, will behave like this. So y will have a maximum value only. because with the increase of x, with the increase of x, y is going towards infinity. So now it's clear for you, IUC. Because Simon had asked why minimum, sir, why not maximum? So Simon, you must be getting this point that if the multiplier of or coefficient of x square is positive, the graph will go upward. So here also the coefficient of x square or this particular whole value, this particular value where it is 1 right now, so this is positive value. So if this positive value is multiplied by x plus 2, so this graph will always go upward, and for any upward going graph there will always be a minimum value. So IUC, you must have been clear with that if there is a equation, let's say 1 minute, so let's say we have two equation, let's say I have two equation in our format only, minus 8 x plus 6 whole square plus 25, and let's say another equation is 6 x minus 3 whole square minus 28. So in both of the equation, what you can easily derive is, the first equation will not have, first equation is downward, moving downward, so it will not have minimum value but a maximum value. So the first equation, how can draw this particular equation as, like we have a x-axis here, and let's say you want to graph this particular so what we know here is with this value 8 will not change the maximum or minimum value of whatever the value we are getting, maximum and minimum, but this particular 8 will just effect on the curve of the particular parabola, whether it's shrinked or expanded. So with 8 we will have a shrinked parabola, and it will have a negatively going parabola, so it will have its maximum value at minus 6, so it will have a maximum value at minus 6, so it should be go like downward, and but since 25 is added to this particular value, so basically this particular curve will start from here where y is 25. So we will be getting a graph like this. So what we know, what we see here is, if 8 is negative, since the coefficient of x plus 6 square is negative, we will always have a downward curve. So with downward curve, this value will represent our maximum value. So what will happen with this particular equation? So here we have 6 x minus 3 whole square minus 28. So with 6, 6 is not going to affect our maximum or minimum value. X minus 3 suggests that graph will have its maximum or minimum value at x is equal to 3, and since it is a positive coefficient, so it will be a upward graph, and since minus 28 is there, so graph will go down minus 28 value of y. So graph will be like this. So there will be a minimum value here, and that is minus 28. So you see, this P can represent sometime maximum or sometime minimum value of your equation. So I believe, I hope you all are clear with this. Thank you. So okay. So Narayan, is it clear for you also? So everyone, if you have understanding, if you are understanding it, please raise your hands, or just you can. Thank you, Anurag. So what we'll do? I'll now start doing questions here. Thanks a lot. So we'll be doing questions here with the different questions which can come into your exams. So let's say if we introduce. Some modulus factor in our quadratic equation, because since we are not solving any, we will not discussing only concepts today, so we will have some questions here with me. Let's say there is a equation x square minus 5 modulus x plus 6 is equal to 0. Now solve this particular equation, and then if you are not if you cannot solve this, please tell me on question bar, so that I will start directly, or I will give you some time to solve it by yourself. So okay, let's 2 minute time to think what we can do with this, and then I'll be explaining you what could be the solution of this particular equation. Okay, what we have to do, Anand, basically this is an equation, so you need to find out value of x for which this particular equation holds true. So what basically the general idea is, not domain, basically this is a particular equation, this is an equation. So you just need to find out for what value of x and this equation holds true. So okay, so basically you should have a general idea. If there is a inequation, like if I say there is one more question for you. If x square plus 5x plus 6, if it is greater than 0, and if I am asking to solve this particular inequation, so basically here you need to find out the range of x where this inequation will hold true. So if this is asked, basically you need to find out range of x where this holds true. So you have two questions here. The first one is involving mode, so, and second one is it's a simple one, this is inequation. So Asita, you are saying x is greater than 3, basically you must be telling me for this equation. Are you telling your answer for this? Okay, so what do we know here is, for solving any inequation, what should you do is, you should change the inequation into equation. So basically x square plus 5x plus 6 is there, you just change it into an equation. So by factorizing is exactly, so Suman, you are right. So x is minus 3 and minus 2. So what should we do is, actually you are getting the question is right, but the answer, everyone who are posting the answer is not correct. So basically I was talking about the range. So basically we will have two roots, minus 3 and minus 2, and if you plot these three roots, so you will always have three zones on a number line. One which is greater than minus 2, one which is in between minus 2 and minus 3, and one which is less than minus 3. So basically you have both the idea here. This particular equation is going upward. Okay Anand, you are right. Basically we have two ranges possible for x. Of course that depend number of roots, because here we are getting two roots, so we have the complete number line in three zones. If we have just one root, then you can just have two different zones here. Like for this equation, x minus 2, for this equation there is one root only. So for this particular range, x should be either less than minus 3 or greater than minus 2. So if you wanted to tell the range, so it would have been x is equal to less than minus 3, and you must write or here, because it's basically the case of adding both of the range, and so the x should be greater than minus 2. That should be greater than 2. So both of these ranges will collectively represent this particular. And what will happen if we add also equality factor here? So both the roots will also be counted with this. So this is what happened for second equation. Now what you can do with this? Of course, Suman, that will depend upon number of roots only. So basically if there is a quadratic equation, the number line, of course. See, let me explain you with a little detail. Like any quadratic equation, say there are three kind of quadratic equation. Let's say x minus 2 is equal to 0. Another one is x square plus 4x plus 8 is equal to 0, and the last you can say is x square plus 4x minus 3 is equal to 0. So what do we know is this particular equation will have just one root. One value, you can say 2. This particular equation will have imaginary roots, and this will have two roots, let's say a and b. So one of these will be smaller and second one will be the same, because if you say ki both of roots are equal, then this is the case of this only. So one of this, if they are both are real, so one of this will be smaller and one of this will be bigger. So what happens if we plot this particular curve? So basically what you will have to do is you have to change this particular equation in our required format. So basically this is x square plus 4x plus 4. So we have added 4 here, so must be subtracted through this particular number. So minus 7 will be there, So finally what you will be getting is x plus 2 minus 7. So what do we know is that this particular curve will start from minus 7 point, and it will up here from here, because x plus 2 is there. So we'll start from minus 2 point. So this particular curve will start from minus 7 point. So minimum value will be the minus 7, and there are two roots here and here. So any particular quadratic equation which have the two roots, that divides number line in three parts. One part is this, one is between the roots, and the last one is right side of the first part. So this particular equation will have just one root, so this will divide the number line in one parts only, and this is in no roots, imaginary roots, so this will have this will not divide x lines. And the last equation which has two roots, a and b, so one of them must be smaller, so it will have three zone. So what do we know is the graph, when we'll draw the graph, there will be three zones, either two are negatives and one are positives. And here what we have is here in this area we have a positive value of I, in this area we have positive value of I, and between the roots we have negative value of Y. So you can just find out through these values also. So just a second. So I believe now you are understanding, Suman. Okay, thank you. So now we have the first equation which involved modulus of x. So what do we have here is let's say we had x square, sorry, so whenever you have some of you are asking some questions, let me see. Manaswani, any quadratic equation will have two roots? No, sir. Exactly not, because some quadratic equation can have one root, and some quadratic equation can have imaginary roots. No, I never said that it will have three roots. You might see the explanation. My idea was, if two roots are there, so if any quadratic equation, let me draw a fresh one, if any quadratic equation, I was not telling you that any quadratic equation will have three roots. What I was saying is that if a quadratic equation is drawn like this, so these two are the roots, and these two will divide the complete x-axis in three parts. One is this side, one is this side, I mean less than the first root and greater than the second root, and another part will have this. So what you can see here is, for any value of x from this side, y will always have positive value, and any value of x in this side, y will always have positive value. This, I mean every point greater than and this particular roots, let's say it is alpha and let's say it is beta. So any point less than alpha will have a positive, and any point between alpha and beta y is always negative. So if we have an equation kind of thing, you can conclude your solution with this particular explanation. So I believe now it must be clear to you, Manaswani. I never told you that it will have three roots, because a quadratic equation has maximum two roots, or it can have one root or it can have two imaginary roots. So if it is clear to you, upside will be positive, will be for positive equation, and down for negative. Of course, matlab it's not like positive equation or negative equation. Basically, if the coefficient of x square is positive, so it will be moving upward, and the coefficient of x square is negative, it will be moving downward. Of course, so you can term this like positive equation or negative equation. However, I have never come to this particular statement. No, there will not be three. It's basically three zones. The two roots will divide the x-axis in three zones. So because we are trying to get the sign of the complete expression, I mean what will happen to the y, it will be positive or negative, or so we have three zones with these two roots. So let's say that like if another curve is like this, let's say if another curve is like this, so this particular quadratic equation have again two roots. This is alpha, this is beta. So this curve is downward, this one curve is moving downward. So what you can see here is every value, this alpha and beta divides the x-axis in three parts. One part is this greater than beta, one part is this less than alpha, and one part is in between alpha and beta. So what do you see here is, if x is greater than beta, y is always negative. Y is going, since y is going downward. And again, if x is less than alpha, y is again negative. So you can also see that y is values. And if x is greater than alpha and less than beta, so value of y is positive. So what is your next question? Let me see. Root is the place where a curve meets x-axis. Exactly. Basically, root is the place where the curve cuts the x-axis, and where you can always say it in other words, where the value of y is zero. So root is the place where the value of y is zero. Did you get my point? Root is the place. Okay. So let's go to, let's solve the particular question that has been given here. So you must be clear with the concept of mode. Like if x is here, so mode is basically magnitude. So you must be knowing that. Let me write here. Mode is basically magnitude of whatever the value is under the mode sign. So what do you see here is, if we break mode, it will always be positive x. So modulus of x is x only if and only if x is greater than or equal to 0, and if modulus of x is equal to minus x, no, only if x is less than 0. Of course, Anand, so this, for this particular equation, we'll have to take cases. We'll have to two cases when x is greater than or equal to 0. So what we will do is, if x is greater than or equal to 0, so what happen? Modulus of x will be x only. So if x is greater than or equal to 0. So that is the defining factor here. So whatever we'll be doing calculation here, whatever the result we'll be getting, we will only take the value which is greater than 0. So give me 1 minute. I'll have to plug in the battery, otherwise the laptop will be dead. So just a second. Okay, Ankit, give me a little time, I'll explain it to you. Yes, Ankit, you are very much right. Modulus is the only positive magnitude of any number. So if you want to represent, like let's say minus 5 is here. Let's say minus 5 is here under the modulus. And you want to represent the value with respect to minus 5 only. So what do you know? So at minus 5, modulus of minus 5 is always 5. Because only positive value we can take. But if you want to represent the same thing with minus 5 only, so you'll have to add a minus also before minus 5. So this is the explanation that you are asking for. I hope you are clear with this. Ankit, So you must have got, because we wanted to express the x thing with x only. So we didn't know x is positive or negative. So what happened, we took both of the cases. In first case, what I am considering x is positive value. So there will not change in sign for x. So what we can get here, what we get here is x plus x square plus 5x plus 6. Is equal to 0, and the two solution that we can get here is I can just draw this solution to number line. The two solution that you will be getting here is minus 3 and minus 2. I believe you must be getting it. So what I'll do, I'll put the smaller root before. This is minus 3, this is minus 2. So this particular equation we are getting two values of x, minus 3 and minus 2, and both of these values are less than 0. So both of these values are less than 0. So our condition that we had through which we had started, that x should always be greater than 0. And we started with saying this key, we'll be dealing where x is greater than 0, but the answer that we are getting here is both of the roots are negative. So we will not take this value. So we will not take this value. So that equation will not have this is not acceptable. So another case that we were having is x is less than 0. So in this case, modulus of x will give you minus x, considering x is less than 0. So the equation will be x square minus 5x plus 6 is 0. So again the square will not change the sign of x square, because even if minus x is there, the x square will be the same, and minus 5x. So again we'll be getting two solutions here, one is 3 and one is 2. So I'll be writing a smaller value first and the greater value next. So again we have two roots of this equation, and both of the roots are greater than 0. Both of the roots are greater than 0. So again this particular value that we are getting through this equation is not acceptable again. So if you have this equation, there will not be any value of x that will satisfy this equation. So if the question is like this, define the value of x which can satisfy this particular equation. Okay Geetam, modulus have positive value. Anand, because okay. Stop writing questions. I will be repeating the thing. First let's take the doubt of Geetam. Geetam, basically modulus have positive value only, that we know, and that everybody can say. But what if if you know, let's say a modulus of x is there, so you want to represent the modulus of x with respect to x only. So let's say if x is positive, so you will not have any problem, you will just say modulus of x is x. But if x is negative or x is less than 0, so you will have to take only positive value of x. So if x is less than 0, to make it positive, what you have to do is you will have to have minus sign before x. So that's why in algebraic equation where you are not clear with the sign of x, so you'll have to take two cases here, x is greater than 0 or x is less than 0. So if x is greater than 0, then modulus of x will be x only, because you will just have the magnitude part here, x only. So your equation will be like this, and the values that you'll be getting here is minus 3 and minus 2. Now we'll come to the answer part. Siddharth, Anand and Suman has asked that why it will not satisfy. The basic assumptions that we had taken here is x is greater than 0 for this case. So all the values that I am getting here is minus 3 and minus 2. X is minus 3 and minus 2, which is less than 0. So the solution that I am getting is not satisfying the condition through by which we have started. So this particular solutions minus 3 and minus 2 is not satisfying this condition. So we cannot take this solution for this equation. I believe you are getting it right this time. And the second case that I took is x is less than 0. I'm already defining x is less than 0. So basically x is negative number, and to make a x positive, my x a negative number to positive, we need to add minus to the x. So in this case the value of x will be minus x. So this is the magnitude here. So the equation will be converted into x square minus 5x plus 6 is equal to 0. So again, while solving, no Ananya, I could have asked that question also. I had just tweaked that question. I thought you have already, we must have already studied these things. So I couldn't, I didn't take minus. So if you take minus 5 modulus x, you will be getting all the values right. So Ananya is saying, what it is minus sign here. So if you could have take minus sign here, you would have all the values that you could get here acceptable. But I intentionally didn't take this minus sign. I took this positive sign to show that if this is positive here, so all the value that we'll be getting through this equation is 2 and 3, and we have assumed that x is less than 0, so this will not satisfy also. So basically you will not have any positive real value of x, any real value of x which can satisfy this particular equation. So let's go to the question, Ananya's questions. Let's say the same equation is written here is like, so you will get the I'll give you the time to solve it. Let's say the another equation is x square minus 3x minus 3x plus 2, this is in modulus format, is equal to 0. Now solve this question. So Ananya must be getting my point. I intentionally didn't ask that. So solve this question. So many of the time, even the CAT and other competitive exam, they does the same. They'll give you such question where you can believe that this is wrong, but basically they are not wrong. They don't want any solution for that particular equation, so they have asked that. So while you're solving these questions, you must remember that you are doing whatever you are doing is right, and they give is equal to 0 of this type of question. Not always, like if it is not equal to 0, you can just move the number left. So Geetam is saying that modulus of minus x is equal to x, modulus of minus x is equal to x, that is right. Of course Geetam, actually what you are confused here with, if we have x in a modulus, so we don't know exactly this x is positive or negative. So my idea is, if x is the positive value, let's say if x is the positive value, so you don't care, we don't care, like if 5 is here in a modulus, 5 is here in modulus, you just write 5. You just don't change the sign of 5. But if this x is negative, like you know this x is negative, so to make that x positive, you will have to add a minus sign before that x, because minus minus positive. So while solving any question based on modulus, if you don't know exact the sign of x or the value of x, whether it is less than 0 or greater than 0, you'll have to add minus sign once a time and plus sign one a time. So Ankit, you are giving me range. I don't know for which question you are giving me range, because this is an equation, and for an equation you will always get a value. So if this is a quadratic equation, so either we will have roots or no roots. You don't have range here. So Ankit, you have given me x is equal to less than minus 1. So let's do the question. You will have again two conditions. In one case, x is equal to x, that means x is greater than or equal to 0. So we will have x square minus 3x, sorry, 0. So what we can get here is as roots. What I'll be doing here is I always write smaller root first and bigger root second. So you will have one or two as roots. So you will have one and two. And what do you see? All these two roots are greater than zero. So this both are possible solution. Not possible. These both are solutions basically. And what if you take a 1 minute. What I am saying here is, if modulus of x is minus x, considering x is less than 0. So if we are considering this is x than 0, so this equation will convert it to, and remember I have not changed the sign of x square, because even if it is minus x, so x square will be positive, so any coefficient is not there, so you don't need to change the sign of x square. So for this equation, what you will get is so all these two roots is also satisfactory here. So any quadratic equation, so they can ask you like a question, let's change the value here, uh, 3x. Yes Geetham, x is less than 0, that means value of x is negative, that's why we have added this minus sign here with x. Okay, so solve this question, find out the roots of this equation. So you have this question. So okay, Anu has asked me, sir, how it possible, for what you are asking actually, I couldn't get which part it feels like it's not possible. Anupriya has asked that how it is possible. So everybody is getting 5 and minus 5, so I think you must be right. And I still have that question that Anupriya has asked, that how it is possible. So what part you are asking this? So let's have, you must be solving all these questions. So IOC you have written 2 and 5, so you need to check this. So let's go to another problem here. This is from CAT. Again Suman, it's not range. You just need to realize that this is an equation, so any equation will not have any range. So equation will always have a value. Like if it was an equation, that it might have got the range of x where this particular inequation could have satisfied that particular characteristics of inequation. But here we have a equation, so you will always have roots for this equation, no inequation, no range. So someone, you need to solve again, like I have did here, and find out what are the values of x which can satisfy this particular equation. So let's go to another question here. This could be also a very good question for you. I have two questions, x square minus 2x minus 8, now we have a inequation here. So you need to find out how many integers shall not satisfy this. How many integers shall not satisfy this? So this is the question you have. And I believe that I have already explained everything to solve this question, so it won't take much time for you. Now take the second question. The second question is, let's have a quadratic equation of this form, ax square plus bx plus 1. This is second question. Ax square plus bx plus 1 is equal to 0. So what do you have is, A and B belongs to the set A and B belong to the set 1, 2, 3, 4. I mean A and B can only have the value of 1, 2, 3, 4. So what they are asking is number of equation that we can form for real roots. So number of equation we can for real roots. So you have these two questions, and meanwhile I will again say you, Suman, that the answer that you have posted is minus 5, x is greater than minus 5 and less than minus 5 is a range. And what I was asking you was the value of x which could satisfy this particular equation. So always remember, if it is asked that solving the equation, you will have values for x. And if it is in equation, you will always have the range. So you have 2 minutes time to solve these two questions. 7 integers. So how did you get that, Anand? Solve the second one then. I'll give you 2 minutes time and then I'll be explaining it to you. So hello everyone. Let's say first question has 7 and question number 2 answer is 4. I don't think so. Let's solve these questions. So what we have here is we will have always have two cases where modulus is involved. If x is greater than 0, so it will be, and for any solving any inequation, what we do is we convert the inequation into equation. So if x is greater than 0, then modulus of x will be x. So modulus of x will be x. So the equation we can write here is 0. So by factorizing, we can say this is x square minus 4x plus 2x plus 8 is equal to 0. So we have two values here, minus 2 and 4. So what we have assumed is x is greater than 0. So the only value which can satisfy here is this. And the second case that we have here is x is less than 0, so modulus of x is minus x. So we have x square plus 2x minus 8 is equal to 0. So what we have here is so we have two roots here. One is minus 4 or one is 2. So what we have is inequation here, and that should be greater than 0. This particular modulus fraction should be greater than 0. So what we know is this is an upward curve. This will be a upward curve kind of thing. So only these reasons are there where this expression are 0. And again, for here also, if this will be like this upward curve. So this reason where we'll have the particular thing is greater than 0. So the value where this satisfied, where you can just write the range which are satisfying. Here you have minus 4, here you have plus 4, including these because it's greater than or equal to 8. So what we have here, we have this range of x where the equation is satisfying, and this range of x where the equation is satisfying. So the only, and including this, including minus 4, so only integer that is left is minus 3 to 0 to 3. So we have 2, 1, minus 1, minus 2. So you have total 7 integers. So whosoever has answer 7 integers. So let's go to the Second question. Let's go to the second question. So here you can have the multiple approaches to solve this question, but the equation was like ax square plus bx plus 1 is equal to 0. So what do we know is we can have real roots only if d is greater than equal to 0. So basically it's b square minus 4ac, and if c is 1, so basically b square into b square minus 4a should be greater than or equal to 0. So what we have is we'll put the values of let's say if a is 1, so then 4a, if a is 1, so b can be b cannot be 1, because basically it will be b square minus 4 should be greater than or equal to 0. So b cannot be 1, so b can have 2, 3 or 4. So if next, if a is 2, so then we will have b square minus 8 should be greater than equal to 0. So b can only have the value of 3 or 4. So let's have the third case. If a is equal to 3, the condition is reduced to so only the value of 4 can satisfy. And lastly, if a is equal to 4, so the equation will be reduced to b square minus 16 should be equal to 0. So here we can only have b is equal to 4. So the total sets that we are getting here is AB, the value of AB for real roots is 1, 2, we'll have 7 sets basically, 1, 3, 1, 4, 2, 3, 2, 4, 3, 4, and 4, 4. So there are 7 sets which can basically satisfy this particular condition. So you will have 7 quadratic expressions with these 4 values of a and b which will have real roots. So I believe you must have been understood this. What is the answer to the first? So I already told you, answer to the first is 7 integers. And Saurav, let me go back to the last slide. For Saurav, it is what we have seen here is this minus 2 is not greater than 0. So Suman, it's not my fault, I think. That must be some network problem. Because at my point of audio is okay. Let me. So Saurabh. Ankit has a very good question. Ankit is saying that let's we have defined plus 4 and minus 4. So for positive value of x, what do we see here is the all the positive value greater than 4, all the positive value greater than 4 will satisfy the condition of the same equation if it is converted to this particular inequation. Because while solving inequation, what do we do is we convert this inequation into equation. So all this positive value of x after 4 will satisfy the inequation. And when we have this particular when we had this particular case where the minus 4 was the acceptable value because x is less than 0. So all the value less than minus 4. Again, if less than minus 4, then it will be less than 0 also. So all the particular value which is less than minus 4 will also satisfy the given condition which is written here. So the anything below 4, including minus 4, below minus 4, less than minus 4, including minus 4. Or anything greater than 4 will satisfy the given condition where x square minus 2 modulus x minus 8 is greater than or equal to 0. Or of course including this minus 4 and this 4. So only integer that is left behind are minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1 and 2. So these are 7 integers or whole numbers which are not there with the range of acceptable range. So I believe Ankit, I have clarified you. So thank you. So the Suman, the answer of the first question is of course 7 integers. And again the answer of the second question was also 7. Because 7 values of 7 sets of values of A and B would satisfy the condition of real roots. So I believe you must have enjoyed this particular session. Earlier I had some complaints about that I don't write much. So I have tried to write as much as possible today, and